Up next, we have our next fight for our eight-man tournament. Charles Murray versus David Rodriguez.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is presented by the Aloft at LaGuardia and is our second quarterfinals bout of this eight-man 135-pound tournament. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, please welcome David Rodriguez.
David, the Cuban Missile Rodriguez, fighting out of the Chino Muay Thai, representing Cuba. Second fight of the eight-man tournament, David coming in with a 9-7 record.
Introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, please welcome Gnarly Charlie Murray.
And this is Gnarly Charlie Murray fighting out the red corner. Fighting at a House of Muay Thai in Norfolk, Virginia. He's coming to this tournament with an 18-8 record. The winner of this fight will go on to fight the winner of the last fight, Dylan Juco.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this contest is presented by the Aloft at LaGuardia and is our second quarterfinals bout in this eight-man, 135-pound contest. This bout is scheduled for 3 2-minute rounds. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, this fighter is 22 years old, standing 5'9" tall. His official weight, 134.6 pounds. He holds a record of 9 wins, 7 losses, coming to us by way of Cuba. He represents Bushido Muay Thai. Please welcome David Rodriguez. Introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This fighter is 29 years old, standing 5'9" tall. His official weight, 134.5 pounds. He holds a record of 18 wins, 8 losses, coming to us tonight by way of Norfolk, Virginia. He represents House of Muay Thai. Please welcome Gnarly Charlie Murray.
Gnarly Charlie. I like that. That's one.
Two of you guys have both great nicknames. Gnarly Charlie and the Cuban Missile. Here we go.
Cuban Missile. Oh, both of you guys. David came in heavy. Fast with the hands right away.
And another fight with no filling out process.
Now you only got 3 rounds. You don't have time to fill it out. Ooh, sends nice high kick from David.
David landed a couple good punches after the high kick. Good lean back by Charlie.
Yeah.
David seems to be the little bit of a more aggressive fighter so far. Good cross
David. Yeah, David really putting the pressure on him a little more, I think.
Charlie snuck in a little bit of a good elbow right there. Good body shot from David. Yeah. Right hand to the body.
Oh, good little sweep from Charles. Ooh, big body kick. Good, David right back with another sweep. Good first round.
Good opening round from these two. I think David might edge that out with the aggressiveness.
I think so. He might have a little more busy with just setting him up a little more. He said he's got a couple boxing fights as well. So he's got a 9-7 Muay Thai record. And then I think he said he has 2 boxing fights. So again, could help with his hands a little bit. Definitely, I box as well. I have some boxing fights of my own. And it increases your hands a lot more in Muay Thai, which scores in the United States. You can add some hands. Big body. Finish with body kick is very highly in the States.
If that's one advantage U.S. would have over the rest of the world is our boxing.
Boxing, yeah.
So if you can develop good hands along with your Muay Thai, you might develop an advantage over most people.
Yeah, I think David might have edged that one out just a little bit. We'll see going into the second round. Both these guys are still very much in it.
Let's see if Charles can adjust to the heavy
high
boxing.
High pace, yeah. I think Charles he's sitting back just a little too much. With only 3 rounds, you got to go right away, especially 3 2-minute rounds. You have no time to spare.
David got that memo. See if Charlie could.
Right to it. As soon as they touch gloves, David sends the hands right away.
Good knee by Charlie.
Good, yeah. There's a big kick under those punches. Scores again really highly.
Big punches.
But David's
from
got
David.
Big flurries. Comes right over the top of that right hand. Ooh, sends the high kick.
David just nonstop pressure.
Oh, big body kick right underneath the elbow. As that body shot. He keeps digging at that body like that. It's very, very tiring.
That's money in the bank. That's gonna.
It takes that energy away.
Round.
Yeah. Yeah, as his corner calling for the body shots again. You take too many body shots like that, it'll really drain your tank.
I would rather get hit in the face 100 times over to take one good
agreed,
body shot.
Agreed, agreed. Ooh, Charles really sending a nice combination through. David digging again to the body, there it is. You can see Charles might be hurt just a little bit in the body, really tucking those elbows in.
You know what, it's funny, you can tell David has a boxing style because that right body is normally not used in Muay Thai.
Yeah.
But you big, see that boxing
big
coming
out. Right body hook is very risky sometimes when you get kicks like that. Oh, there's big knees.
Oh, big knees
yeah,
in a clinch.
Those knees
hurts
are landing
Charlie.
Hard.
Standing
again,
count.
All those between the body kicks, the punches to the body, his body that might be hurt a little bit after those knees.
I think David came in with a good game plan to attack the body. Pays off and he gets the 8 count here.
Yeah,
see
for sure.
Charlie could fight his way back in.
Definitely, it's hard. Charles is going to have to really turn it up now after that 8 count. Oh, right away though, he's still in it for sure.
Charlie's tough, man. He's good combinations.
Oh. Gnarly Charlie really coming out fast after that 8 count.
Good way to finish after an 8 count, but it might have been a little too late.
Yeah, I think there wasn't enough time after that. I think he's probably got to give it to David. He's probably up two rounds now after that 8 count.
Gnarly Charlie's corner is trying to hype him up a little bit. You probably know they need to knock
yeah,
out the
way. Yeah, they need something big. Definitely tell you, after that, I mean, that last 10 seconds, he still has some in the gas tank. But can he really execute in this third round? We'll see.
These tournaments have been war so far. Even if you win, you might come out a little banged up.
Yeah, it's a guarantee. You got every fight, even if you dominate all three, smoke the dude, you are definitely coming out with some bumps and bruises. And these guys got to fight in let's see, one, two, three. They get four fights off.
Yeah, they're right back in a ring. And
four fights, that's about an hour. You only get an hour off. But here we are in our third, going in our third round.
Gnarly Charlie Murray in the red corner versus David the Cuban Missile.
Ooh. Slip.
David seems strong, man, for 135.
Yeah, he's long. He's got a nice little reach on him, too, for 135. Ooh, Charlie really sending those kicks, too, now.
Charlie has some beautiful techniques of his own, but it just seems he has problems with David's flurry of boxing.
You can see the redness on Charlie's body a little bit between the kicks and the punches. But he's got a nice, good little left kick to him.
He does. The left kick has probably been Charlie's best strike.
Yeah.
This is not where you want to be when you're down two rounds. You have to go for it.
You have to really give it all you got.
Seems like David just has a little more gas in that tank. It might have been the body shots.
Yeah, I mean, they definitely take a toll after so many. Two rounds like that with that many body shots. They tie back up again.
They both seem to be resting a little here.
Man, after two very high-paced rounds, I don't blame them either.
Yeah, I do the same thing in my fights.
Take a second to breathe.
Yeah.
There's that body shot again. You could tell that hurt him a little bit. Oh, there it is. Oh. His coach threw in the towel, I think.
Yeah.
Fight's over, yep. Wow.
David, the Cuban Missile, Rodriguez.
Cuban Missile.
Third round knockout. Charlie's corner actually threw in the towel.
It was those body shots.
Charlie's
really doing
tough
the damage.
For his own good. He was ready to stay in there and
he
fight.
He was in it, but
he
I mean.
He took some vicious body
yeah,
shots.
At the end of the day, it's a smart call by the coaches just to save. You don't want to take extra damage if you don't need to.
That's why the coach is there for, to protect his fighter. And
exactly.
The coach did the right thing. No point. The fight was ready in the third round. Charlie with a ready down, why take more punches?
Yeah, exactly. Beautiful performance by both these guys, though. David really just was really smart with those body shots between body kicks, body punches, and that last little liver shot. Man, you've ever been hit by a liver shot, it is probably the most excruciating pain I've ever experienced in my life.
100%. It shuts down your whole body.
It's one of those, like, delayed pains. It takes about 5 seconds to kick in, and then I literally thought I was dying.
And it's like one of those things where it's against your will. It doesn't matter how strong you are.
No, it literally shuts down your whole body. So props to him for literally taking it like a champ. Took it. You could tell it hurt him a little bit. He got right back up. But, again, it's coach's call at the end of the night, protecting his fighters. But both respect to both these guys.
I wonder if that's David's game plan for tonight, body shots. He really seems to go to it a lot tonight.
It'd be smart of him.
Yeah.
It really takes a toll on an opponent if you're taking body shots like that, drain them, without taking damage on your own.
Sometimes that's the difference, the body shots. And not a lot of fighters in the heat of the moment utilize that technique. You have to see it. You have to be able to land it.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, at 1 minute and 54 seconds into round number three, your referee has called a halt to this contest, declaring your winner by TKO, David Rodriguez!
David Rodriguez, winner by third round TKO. He'll advance, he'll fight Dylan, right? That'll be a matchup for sure.